Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. Every online multiplayer game requires a stable internet connection between the clients and the server. But how do you know that you have that? Luckily, Overwatch provides us with a lot of info that helps us to identify problems with our connection to the game server. But the amount of info is quite overwhelming, so in this video we will have a look at all the values and I will explain what they mean. So let's begin with the performance information overlay, which you can enable by pressing right shift, Control and R. FPS stands for frames per second. That's how many frames per second the game is currently rendering. The frame rate is not just affecting how fluid the player movement looks on your screen, it also affects how fast the game responds to your input. That's why you should not just aim for a minimum of 60 frames per second, but more importantly, a stable 60 frames per second. If your frame rate goes up and down between 30 and 80, then you will notice that in the game because that constantly changes the responsiveness of the game, and that affects your aim and movement. You should always consider to lower a few of those graphic options to achieve a stable frame rate of at least 60 frames per second. If you have a gaming monitor which supports a refresh rate of more than 60Hz, like 120 or 144, then you should obviously aim for that as your frame rate in order to get the most out of your setup. Then we have TMP, which is the current temperature of your GPU. If your GPU gets too hot, then it will usually try to protect itself by reducing its clock speed, which means that you will see an FPS decrease. However, it's also possible that the whole system will just crash. It's bad when your GPU runs too hot, as that can cause permanent damage. To find out how hot is too hot, you need to check the specifications of your GPU or graphics card. If the game runs at an unnecessarily high frame rate, like mine here, then you can consider to use the limit FPS option, as that might also lower your GPU temperature in case that you are GPU limited. So what you can choose from here is 30 FPS and display based. 30 FPS will just limit your frame rate to 30, while display based will limit it to a value that is slightly higher than the refresh rate of your monitor. So if you use 60Hz, then it will limit your frame rate to slightly above 60. And if you use 144Hz, then it will limit the frame rate to a bit more than 144, as you can see here. Instead of using the FPS limiter, you can also enable VSync, which will lock the frame rate to the refresh rate of the monitor and get rid of tearing. However, VSync will also increase your input lag, so you have to decide what is more important for you here. I want as little input lag as possible, so I always play without VSync and just go for the display-based FPS limit. Then we have PNG, which stands for ping. Now, what is that and where does the term come from? If you've seen the movie The Hunt for Red October, then you might remember that scene where Sean Connery gave the order to check the distance to the US submarine with one active sonar ping. And one ping only, please. The way this works is that your ship sends out an audio signal, which then gets reflected by other objects in the water. And on your ship you have microphones, which then hear that reflection. If you then measure the time between sending the audio signal and receiving the reflection, then you can calculate the distance between you and the object. The ping that we talk about for network connections between different devices is pretty much the same thing. Your device sends an ICMP echo request to another network device, like a game server, which then sends an ICMP echo reply back to your device. Now, if you measure the time between sending the request and receiving the reply, then we can get the ping or round trip time of the data. So the ping tells us how long the data has to travel through the copper and fiber optic cables to reach the other device. And the longer it has to travel, the bigger the difference between what we see on our screen and what the other player sees on theirs, which is what we call lag. Then we have the RTD or round trip time, which is very similar to the ping. However, this value will always be a bit higher because it shows how long it takes your client to receive a response from the server after you made the command in the game. So unlike the ping, this value is about the actual game data. This means that when both your ping and the round trip time values increase together, then you might have an issue with your connection. While when the ping does not change and only the RTD value increases, then it's more likely that the game client or the game server has a problem. And you can't do much about that. The next one is IND, which stands for interpolation delay. Smooth player movement and actions is what we want to see on our monitor. To achieve that, the game has a small buffer, which stores the information it receives from the server, fills the gap, and then displays it on your monitor. In normal games, this interpolation delay is about 50 to 60 milliseconds, while in custom games it appears to be around 30 milliseconds when you use the high bandwidth option. The interpolation delay is not affected by your ping. However, when you suffer from packet loss, then it will increase quite significantly, and that will result in gameplay issues. When we now use right shift, control and N to enable the network graph, then we are presented with quite an overwhelming amount of information. So when you see a large white bar here, then this indicates that it takes your computer way longer than expected to process the data it receives from the server. While a large orange bar means that the latency exceeds the interpolation delay. And the numbers that you see here are the minimum, average and maximum values for each of these elements. So, the first one, sim, stands for simulation. It's the time that your client needs to process a tick. But what is that, a tick? Overwatch uses a tick or simulation rate of 60, which means that we have about 16 milliseconds between them. When a tick starts, then the game will process the data it received, it will run its calculations, and then send the results. After that, it will sleep until the next tick happens. So these 16.66 milliseconds are the time frame inside which the tick must be finished, as otherwise the game would not be able to maintain its simulation or tick rate, which would result in massive gameplay problems. So when we see a sim value of 6.5 milliseconds in the net graph, then this means that this is the time it took the game to finish the tick. And at a tick rate of 60, you are fine as long as the value stays below 16. So this is how it should work, but during my tests I noticed something strange. When the game ran at 266 frames per second, then I got a sim value of 3.8 milliseconds. With 154 frames per second, I got 6.5 milliseconds. With 69 frames per second, I got 14.3 milliseconds. And with 30 frames per second, I got a simulation value of 32.3 milliseconds. So it looks like the framerate has some kind of effect on the simulation, and it gets even more confusing when we do a few calculations of our own. It's really strange to see that direct correlation between the framerate and the sim value. Maybe the game client does not use a fixed simulation or tick rate of 60, or there's something wrong with the value here that is displayed for the sim value in the net graph. I don't know what exactly is going on here, but if I can get any more info on that, then I will include it in one of my upcoming videos. Next one is IND or interpolation delay that we have already talked about. Then we have LAT or latency. This shows us for how long the game client has not heard from the server. If you wonder how that latency value can be lower than the ping, then this is very easy to explain. The latency is just the trip from the server to the client, while the ping is the round trip time. It's normal to see small spikes here, and you should not encounter any problems in-game as long as this value is smaller than the interpolation delay. Then we have PNG and RTD, which we already talked about before, and that brings us to the CMD queue or command queue. So when the client sends a command to the server, then it awaits a confirmation from the server that it received that command. The command queue value shows you how many commands the server has not acknowledged yet. And you will see that this value increases when your ping increases. The next ones are packets per second incoming and packets per second outgoing. First of all, it's important to understand that these update rates have nothing to do with the tick or simulation rate of the game, so make sure that you don't confuse them. So PPS in tells us how many times per second we receive data from the server, which is about 20 times in normal games and 60 times in custom games when you use the high bandwidth option. However, it will not always stay at the exact same value. You will notice that it spikes when you see the kill cam, during replays, and close before the match starts or ends. The PPS out value shows us how many times per second the client sends data to the server. Normally this is done about 60 times per second. However, if you lock the frame rate to 30, then this will also lower the send rate of your client. Next ones are loss in and loss out, which gives us a percentage value of how much data did not reach its destination. It's obviously bad when data gets lost, however you should not encounter any problems as long as you don't have consistent packet loss or very frequent packet loss. So now that we learned about all these different values, we should have a look at the network icons that you might have seen already on your monitor. This icon here shows up when the time since your client has last heard from the server is greater than your current interpolation delay. This means that when your IND or interpolation delay is 52 and your LAT or latency is 60 milliseconds, then this will trigger that icon. So you will see that icon a lot when you have a high ping or ping spikes. What I noticed during my tests was that when the game ran at a frame rate of more than 260 frames per second, then I would get that icon quite frequently. But as soon as I enabled the display-based option for the FPS limiter, this issue disappeared. I don't know why this happens, but if you have the same problem, then you can try to also enable that limiter. Maybe it works for you too. Then we have the packet loss icon here, which tells you that some of your data did not reach the server, or that some of the data sent from the server did not reach you. Obviously, it's bad when data does not reach its destination, and depending on how much data is lost, you will experience problems in-game like rubber banding, shots not registering, etc. Packet loss is not caused by the distance between you and the server. Many people think that high-ping players automatically also have packet loss, but that is not the case. One of the most frequent causes of packet loss is network congestion. You can think of that like a traffic jam. Your data simply does not get through the network because it's currently maxed out or down for a very short amount of time. This is very common when you use Wi-Fi or powerline, so for gaming these two should be avoided at all costs. It can also be caused by faulty network hardware, including cables, as well as faulty drivers or firmware. So, if restarting your router fixes the issue, then you should have a look if there is a firmware update available. Or you can use a power socket timer to force a restart once per day. But if you only experience packet loss in a specific game or on servers in a specific region, then you should try to contact the support of your internet service provider, as they might be able to change their routing to get rid of the packet loss. But I also have to note that the thresholds used for these icons are currently very low, which means that you might see them while you don't actually experience any problems in-game. So currently there is no reason to be concerned unless you see them constantly or very frequently. And that's it. I hope that I could help you to get a better understanding of what all those network values mean in Overwatch and how you can use them to troubleshoot your connection problems. If you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.